डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू आवर नेक्स्ट सेशन ईपी लेक्चर। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग टुडे सेशन, लेट मी टेक ए कन्फर्मेशन। सो माई स्क्रीन इज विजिबल एंड माई वॉइस इज ऑडिबल, राइट? प्लीज रेस्पॉन्ड स्टार्ट एज 1111।
यस सर, यस सर,
थैंक्स। Thank you. So 1111, you are entering. That means you can able to listen and able to see my screen. Okay, fine. Let me take a new text file for today's session. Okay. So before starting today's session, let me give you a small recap of what we had discussed in our last session. In our last session, I have given introduction to servlets. So and I have started the session with the classification of Java to SE. Java 2 Enterprise Edition, Java 2 Millennium Edition or Mobile Edition. And then I slowly move to explain what is the purpose of servlet, why you are writing servlet, and we try to understand the need of servlet from MVC architecture, model, view and controller point of view. Second, let me change the permissions. We have understand the servlet, the purpose of servlet and the role of servlet through MVC model, model view control architecture. And then we have seen how to define servlet. And there are three different approaches for creating a servlet. One is by implementing the servlet interface. Second one is by extending the generic servlet or by extending the HTTP servlet. There are three different approaches. We have been following HTTP servlet class. That means you are writing a class demo extends HTTP servlet. You are making your demo program servlet by extending your class as a child class from HTTP servlet. And we have seen couple of examples. So during the process, we have learned the role of web.xml file. So it is heart of the servlet program. To execute servlet program, the web.xml file is heart. So once you complete your program, we need to work with web.xml file. In web.xml file, there have some set of tags. The root element is web app. There you need to configure servlet name and servlet mapping. And I have given clearly what is the role of each and every tag. The important tag is URL pattern. With that, I have concluded our yesterday session, right? So this is the recap of yesterday class. Now today we are going to discuss about very, very important topic. Right? Config, it is an interface. Remember students, normally you will forget which one is class, which one is interface. You are not in a position because you might be in a confusion state. After learning couple of classes, interfaces and names, you will get in a confusion state. So now I am talking about servlet config. It is an interface. Remember, it is not a class, it is an interface. Now what is the purpose of the servlet config class? Servlet config interface, sorry. So whenever you are creating a project, so you are dumping everything into your server. So that is nothing but your web container. You are placing all your .class file, you are working with web.xml file. In future, you are going to place some images files, some text files, audio files. Depending upon the requirement, you are placing all your files into web container. Your server is nothing but web container. It is the place where it contains all your files, all your source codes, all your .class files, all your required files, including web.xml file, all deployment descriptor file. Everything you are dumping inside one location. Where is that server? That is called web container. That means, let me write. Your servlet data, your required files, web.xml file, everything you are putting inside a web container. So what will happen whenever you try to run your program, whenever you try to run your servlet, by default your server, by default your web container will create a reference, will create an object to this servlet config interface. So let me make that is a point to put it in, to put it the whole discussion in a single point. your web container server in this in your case will create a reference or object to servlet config interface. This is the point. So try to understand theoretically. If once I complete the discussion in theory, the same thing I will demonstrate with an example. So that example will clear all your doubts if you have any. So the point is, your server, that means your web container will create one reference variable to servlet config interface. So then you may get a doubt why it is creating and what is the need of that reference variable object. So the main purpose of this is to pass some configuration information. If you want to pass some data from web.xml file, from deployment descriptor file to your servlet, if you want to pass some parameters, suppose you are calling one function, you want to pass some parameters. So during function invocation time, you are giving parameters. In the function definition, you are trying to access all the parameters. Similarly, whenever your servlet is running in the background, so from web.xml file, if you want to pass some parameters to that particular servlet, you can able to pass. So in that context, when you want to pass some parameters from web.xml file to any servlet, this servlet config reference variable or object is useful. If still it is confusion, whatever I am telling, if you are still you cannot able to visualize, let me put it in a picture so that you can understand. So assume, let me run. This is your server. So inside, what is happening? You are writing one web.xml file. This is your web.xml file. And here one servlet is there. Here one more servlet is there. For example, three servlets you are writing inside server. Now, when client, so he is a client, he makes a request to server. So what server will do? The server will contact web.xml file and it identifies S1 he is requesting. So S1 will run. Now, this is the scenario. Now, what is the objective of the servlet config is, whenever a particular servlet is running, for every servlet, by default, the servlet config is available. You no need to create any servlet config reference variable. So your server by default will create an object for the servlet config. And it is made available to the servlet one. For example, he is making request for S2. S2 is loaded into memory, it is running. That means the servlet config is made available to S2. In S2, you can readily use this servlet config. Now you are asking a doubt. You are getting a doubt. What is the need? The need is, so whenever this particular servlet one is running, during the running time, I want to pass some extra parameters to the servlet one. In this case, servlet one. So from web.xml file, you can configure all the parameters. Whatever parameters you want to pass to this S1, you can configure in web.xml file. Then when the server is starting, when the server picks up to load S1, then S1 is loaded. During the loading time, with the help of the servlet config reference variable, it will pick all the parameters. Whatever parameters you wish to pass in web.xml file, you can configure everything. These parameters will go to S1. So during the execution time of S1, this S1 will use the parameters which you are passing from the web.xml file. That is the meaning. Now let me put it inside. Let me write the same statement. Select config object. Can be used to get information from .xml file. This is the meaning. So with the help of the servlet config object only, you can able to get the information from m.xml file. So in this, what is the meaning here? So here, this is m.xml file. In the m.xml file, you are setting some parameters. For example, a is equal to 10. Assume b is equal to 20. You are setting these parameters. You want to send this m.xml file to any particular servlet, say s1. So how will you pass this parameter? This reference, this servlet config object is useful. So whether you are going to create this one, you no need to create. This is by default, your web container will create this reference. What type of reference it is? It is a servlet config reference. That is the meaning. Then, so this theory is enough. So directly we will try to understand the concept from an example. Now before going to the example directly, first we should know how to write the parameters, how to put the parameters inside the web.xml file. So you already know how to write the web.xml file. So this is the web.xml file. So this is the web.xml file, you are already familiar. Now this is web app, this entire thing is web app. So whatever information you are writing, this entire thing is representing one servlet. Entire thing is representing one servlet. For example, now you want to write one more servlet, then what will happen? This entire thing you need to repeat one more time. So servlet, for example, this is s1. For example, you want to put one more information in the same web.xml file, what do you have to do? Again, you need to write servlet mapping URL pattern. Inside servlet mapping, then here you need to write s2. So this means, so for every servlet, you need to update a web.xml file. You are not going to update this one. Automatically, when you create a new servlet, automatically your Eclipse will create this, all these tags, and put the corresponding name. If you give the file name is s2, then automatically the entire thing will be created and will make the corresponding changes. Now, in this, this is the basic structure of web.xml file. Now, from this web.xml file, how to configure the parameters. From the web.xml file, you are going to send the information. Then in this XML file, where to put the information. So for that one, try to understand the updated XML thing. Now here, normally this is servlet. So here you are going to write this information, init param, understand? The tag name is init-parameter and the closing with init-parameter. So inside again there are two parameters, parameter name and parameter value. Parameter name is closing and parameter value. Any confusion? So here parameter name is tag starting and parameter name is ending. So inside you are giving the parameter name. What is my parameter name? For example, in this case, I am writing config p1 means configuration parameter 1. What is the value I am giving? KLCE. For example, I want to pass two parameters. So this is first parameter. Suppose I want to pass second parameters. How to give? Again, I need to repeat the same tags, same set of tags one more time. Init parameter. So parameter name, parameter value. What is my parameter name? Config p2, configuration parameter p2. You can write anything. For example, here I will write a, here I will write b. That is also fine, no issues. The thing is how to set parameters. So this is the way of putting the parameter name and corresponding parameter value inside your web.xml file. So for this is representing the first one. I want to pass three parameters. So how many times it has to be repeated? Three times. I want to pass four parameters. So you try to notice everything must be included in servlet only. Understand? So you try to understand this complete box. With parameter 1, this is parameter 2, this is parameter 3, this is parameter number. How many number of parameters you wish to pass, that many number of times this init param tag need to be repeated. Inside init parameter, what you should do, right? Parameter name and parameter value. Inside you need to give, this is this you can consider as a variable, this thing you can consider as a value. Understand? Init param, parameter name, parameter value, and try to notice the location where you are writing. This is servlet. I try to understand, this is servlet. Now let me go back to your previous web.xml file. So this is your web.xml file. Now try to tell me in which location you are keeping. This is the place you are keeping all those things. Yesterday you already know servlet tag is starting, servlet tag is closing. Then servlet name here s1 you have given and s1 you have given. So after this servlet class you need to write this one. This implies init parameters, init parameter and closing init parameter. Inside parameter name, parameter value, closing of parameter name and closing of parameter value. So this entire thing is representing one parameter. So here if you want to pass three parameters, so here you need to write three parameters. Now I will write it here. For example, let me write, this is your web app, and you are closing up web app. So this is by default will be created for every servlet by the Eclipse. So servlet and then servlet and then servlet hyphen, I am not writing completely, you try to understand the structure, servlet hyphen mapping. So this is the structure you are already familiar. So here what you are going to write, here you are going to write yesterday syntax only I am telling here. Servlet hyphen name, servlet hyphen class. So here the corresponding things, the corresponding closing thing you will write, and here also you will write corresponding thing. So here I am introducing new thing. Here you need to write, here what you need to write, init hyphen param, init hyphen param. Inside how to set the values, parameter name, parameter value. Now try to see the complete example. If you notice the updated XML file, now if you notice this updated XML file, this is total web.xml file. Now yesterday you are already familiar servlet tag and servlet tag, servlet mapping, inside tags also you are familiar, this one also you are familiar. Now what is the new thing I am telling? This is the thing. So init parameter, so in which location I am writing? Inside of servlet, before servlet opening and before servlet closing you need to write this particular thing. This is called servlet config parameters. This is called servlet. For example, here I want to pass a is equal to 10. So here I am writing a and value is 10. So for example, I want to pass a is equal to 10 and b is equal to 20. So this entire thing is representing first parameter. I want to pass one more time. So how to control C and control V, and you change it as b and you change it as 2. So now here how many parameters I am passing? This is my first parameter, this is my second parameters. The location you try to notice where I am writing, the entire thing I am writing inside the servlet tag. This is the point I want to stress. Any confusion? Let me take a confirmation. Did you understand any confusion how to configure the initialization parameters inside your web.xml file? When you create a web.xml file, by default Eclipse will create only these things: web app, servlet mapping. But these things will not be created by your Eclipse manually. It is the responsibility of the programmer. You have to go to web.xml file and you have to write all the parameters, servlet configuration parameters. Any confusion? If you understand the syntax of writing this servlet thing, please respond as 2222. So this is first parameter, this is second parameter. For example, you want to pass four parameters, so here you need to write, here you need to write one more thing, here you need to write one more init parameter. So if you notice, the location, everything is must be a part of servlet and servlet closing. You try to notice the location where we are configuring all the values. So here this is first parameter, this is second parameter, this is third parameter, fourth parameter, fifth parameter, sixth parameter. Now one more question I will ask you, then directly I will go to the example. Now if you are okay with this, so many people are responding positively. 2222. Yes, many people can be able to understand. I can see many positive replies. Now the point is, this is not required. Now you have understand how to configure in web.xml page. Now we will see one more code snippet, then how to access these values inside your servlet. The next thing is, you successfully we have configured. Now the thing is, let me draw one picture. So this is your server, this is your web.xml file, and you have used init parameters. You have successfully used init parameters configured. Now this is my S1. Now the thing is, when client is making a request to server, this is server. Client is making a request server. Server will go to web.xml file. With the help of URL pattern, it identifies the S1. S1 is loaded. Now you have added some extra parameters. Now the question is, how to get these values inside of this S1? Understand? So now you try to see this one. Inside your particular servlet, if I want to get the values. So I made one statement initially. So what is the statement? By default, the object will be available. What kind of object it is? Servlet config. You are passing parameters, right? Those are called configuration parameters. So the object is readily available. So how to get the reference of that one? So in your servlet, you need to understand this one. So there is one function called get the servlet config. Get servlet config. So this will give you the reference to the user defined variable. This is servlet config. So how do you get the reference? Your web container, your server will create. So how to fetch that one? To fetch that one, the function name is get the servlet config. Now that will give the reference to config. Now with the help of config, get init parameter. What is your parameter in your example? Let me write. In your program, how to write? So this statement is fine. The next statement, how to write? Some A is equal to config dot get init parameter of inside what is the variable name you have given A in our example. Similarly, the same thing. String B is equal to config dot get init parameter of what is the second parameter B. So now you try to understand what is this A in place and what is this B in place. This A and this B are configured inside web.xml file. Yes, init param inside parameter name, P name you have given A, and then P value we have given some value 10. So here in this case, this A is nothing but A, and what is the value of here A? This is parameter name, this is parameter value. Get init parameter of A. What is the name A? What is the value 10? This 10 will go. Similarly, we have written one more thing is parameter name is B. You have written parameter value some 20 you have given. The second example, get init parameter of B. So this is representing B, and this V value is the thing, but this is any confusion. Now if you understand this one theoretically, now we will see one complete example that will give you a complete picture of the scenario. Is it fine? Shall we proceed? Please respond as 3333. If you say okay, I will proceed with example. please respond as 3333. Okay, perfect. So I make you people understand the concept theoretically. Now I will put all these theory concepts into program, so it will make some sense. So let me open Eclipse. So I will do it somewhat fast, you try to catch up. So what I will do is, yesterday I have created a demo rate. We will go with this one, Java Resources SRC. So yesterday we have created my servlet. Try to notice, this is our yesterday program, my servlet demonstration. Now what I will do is, I will create a new servlet. I will create a new servlet for you here. So how to create new servlet? So right click on your SRC, go to new and create servlet. What is my servlet name? Let me give my servlet name is demo underscore servlet config. Try to notice the class name I am giving. What is the class name? Demo underscore servlet config. Now let me next, click on next and then finish. Now it is created. So now what I will do is, directly we need to go to doGet. So here normally we will use post method. Inside post method is calling doGet. So I directly will go to doGet. So this is my doGet method. So remaining things, let me delete if at all it is confusing you. All the documentation I am deleting to make this program to look simple. I am deleting all unnecessary things. Now this data also I am deleting. This is also not required for me. Now I am at the right location. Now I have to write the code. So what is the first thing? So instead of writing, let me copy it from the yesterday program. So what is that? My servlet. What is the content I have written? So response.chat content type, print writer. These two things are required. Copy. So inside what I have to write, we need to create response type. If you want to display some output in my browser, we require the print writer. So here io, okay, here I will write io dot star, then everything will becomes easy, everything will come. Now print writer is okay. Now before writing anything further inside your servlet, we need to go to XML file first, because we need to set the parameters first. So where the XML file is available, go to web content, webinf, go to web.xml file. Now it is the right time to notice it clearly. So why here new servlet is not created? Yes. Now let me take some space here so that you can understand. This is your yesterday servlet. This is your today servlet. Try to notice here. So this is your yesterday servlet, right? My servlet one, my servlet one. Here I have given servlet name and URL pattern. Now if you notice, you have created in your project, you have created a new servlet. Try to notice whether the new servlet is also created in the same app.xml file or not. So how many people have been noticed? Please respond as 4444 whether new servlet is automatically updated in the yesterday XML file or not. In the deployment descriptor, all the servlets will be updated in one web.xml file. Yesterday I forgot one important point to tell. So for example, in your project you are creating 5 servlets, say S1 S2 S3 S4 S5. So total 5 servlets are there. So total 5 web.xml files will be created. Is it true or false? How many number of servlets are there, that many number of web.xml files created or not? Please respond as yes or no. If my project contains 3 servlets, 3 web.xml files created, say yes or no. Respond as yes or no. Some people are telling yes. I don't know why it is yes. For your entire web application, for your kind information, I am telling you, this is also one of the very, very important question for our placement interview. For your entire web application, there will be only one and only one web.xml file. It will not create number of web.xml files. it will create only one web.xml file. There will be only one deployment descriptor file. All your servlets will be configured within the same XML file. For your information, I do repeat one more time. Some people are giving wrong answer. They are telling yes, your answer is wrong. Irrespective of number of servlets you are creating in your web application, in your project, irrespective of number of servlets you are creating, there will be only one web.xml file. Try to see this. This is your project. Now you tell me, those who are responding as yes, how many web.xml files are there? Now till now we have created two servlets. That means two XML files must be there. But how many XML files are there? There is only one XML file. But what is happening? Within the same XML file, all your servlets will be configured. So how it is configured? Try to notice. So this is your yesterday servlet, my servlet one. Now we just now we have created one more servlet. What is my servlet name? What is my class name? Try to notice this one. What is the servlet class name? Demo_servlet_config. What is your servlet name? Then what is your servlet name here? What is your URL pattern here? Everything is created just like yesterday program only, right? No confusion, right? If there is no confusion, please respond as 5555. Then I will configure init parameters. If you give me confirmation, then I will proceed. Now the time is 3:48. We have only 20 minutes time. I must complete this program for today class. Fine. Many people are giving positive replies. So now I already discussed in which location we need to write our initialization parameters. I have shown you this is the place. This is the place where we need to configure our parameters. Inside servlet tag, or this is servlet tag, this is servlet closing tag. This is the place, right? So here now you tell me. Now you have to tell here what I have to write. How to configure parameters? You please tell me. I have already told you the syntax. What is the root tag name here? I want to pass two parameters. Now init hyphen param. So init param, I want to pass first parameter, init hyphen param. Now what is my first parameter? Param hyphen name. What is my second tag? Param hyphen value. So two things are created, right? Now what I will do is I will simply copy and I will paste it here one more time. Try to notice here, yeah, parameter name. So for example, my parameter name is let me write a to make you understand. I am writing 10. My second parameter name is b and I am passing my parameter name is 20. Now here try to notice, this is my servlet. So try to notice in which location I am putting all these values, where I am configuring all your servlet config parameter values. Inside your servlet tag, this is my closing tag. So this is my first one, this is my second configuration. So how I am putting? Init parameter. What is my parameter name? A. What is my parameter value? 10. Understand? So how many times you repeated that one? Two times you have repeated. That means how many parameters you are passing? Two parameters. What is my parameter name? A. What is my second parameter name? B. So I want to access this E value. I want to access this B value inside your servlet. So no confusion with respect to web.xml file updation, right? So did you understand how I am updating your web.xml file? Please respond as 6666 if you understand how I am writing initialization parameters. How many initialization parameters I am setting? Two parameters I am setting. So with respect to web.xml file, everything is done. So let me close this one. So let me close the web.xml file also. Now go back to your servlet. So I have mentioned here how to access that one. Just now I have shown you how to access that one. So we are first, we need to get the servlet config. Instantiation is required. So how to get the servlet instantiation? Servlet config. So let me write C servlet config C fig. Let me write the variable name is servlet cfg, to put it simple, servlet config. So how to get that one? Get servlet config. Now it is showing some error. Why it is showing error? Because the servlet config need to be imported from javax.import. So now if you try to notice, it is updated. So try to notice this one. To use servlet config, javax.servlet.servlet.config need to be imported. So once I click done, it is automatically imported. Now configuration object is ready. Now how to access the values? How to access? With the help of get init parameter. So let me write some string s1 is equal to, so cfg dot get init parameter. Get, it is automatically coming. Init parameter. So what is my first parameter? Go to your web.xml file. How many parameters you have configured there? Two parameters. What is my first parameter name you have given? A. So then how to use that one? It's in double quotations. You write the A. So I want to take the second one also. Let me copy and paste it inside. This is my second one, and my parameter name is B. Now I want to display in my browser. So how to display in browser? out dot println. So what I want to display, I just simply display s1. The first parameter is s1. Now let me copy and paste it in second line. Let me make it into s2. Now let me explain. This is the code. So now take red color. Now, so this statement you are already familiar. I no need to explain. This is the new statement I should explain. So here this syntax I have already told you. So get servlet config is a method which is responsible to get the configuration reference variable which is created by web container. That means your server. So that will be fetched from the server and will be allocated to our variable. What kind of variable it is? Servlet config variable. So scfg, servlet config. Intentionally I am writing my variable name is sc, servlet configuration variable. So then how to get the value? With the help of get init parameter. Get init parameter is my method name. How to access? With the help of the corresponding reference variable. Here what is the significance of this A? This A is the name and this B is the name which you have configured in your web.xml file. Now if you understand, let me execute this one. So in output we are expecting 10, 20. The first parameter is, second parameter is. Now let me run this on server. Try to notice. Did you notice the output? The first parameter is 10 and the second parameter is 20. So how this 10 and 20 are getting? Go to your XML file. So here A is equal to 10, B is equal to. For example, now here I modify A is equal to 10. I'm writing some text. Let me save this file and let me refresh. Let me refresh this one. If it is refreshing, it is not coming, then in that case we need to run the program again. Try to notice the updated value should come in your output. Try to notice. Did you notice the output? The updated values are coming. Did you understand how these values are coming? Where it is being fetching from? Which location? If you understand the execution, please respond as 7777. if you understand the whole discussion and whatever I have explained, the thing I demonstrated, if the everything is okay, please respond as 7777. Let me see your responses. How many people are able to follow the class? So yes, good. Many people are giving positive reply. So that means you are following very well. Fine. Now I will tell you the purpose. So for your understanding, I have passed the values A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20, some value Vijayawada, and some random data I am passing. But what is the use of this servlet config in real time? How best you can use this facility? You can call this one as a facility. For example, let me tell you one scenario. Concept is over. Now I am telling the purpose of here. S1 is there. S1 is one servlet. S2 is one servlet. S3 is one servlet. S4 is one servlet. S4 is one servlet. Got it? Now what I want to do is assume for these servlets I want to pass some data and I want to configure in the web.xml file and I want it should be reflected in all the servlets. I want to pass some information, a common information. I want to pass some common information from web.xml file. From web.xml file, I want to pass to servlet for all the servlets. In this case, in the web.xml file, in the XML file, wherever there is a servlet configuration for S1, S2, if you configure, that information will go to particular servlet. Though here, the limitation. Now let me tell you about the limitation of this one. For example, I am using S1, S2, S3, S4. So S4 is having database connection, S2 is having some database connection, S3, S4 also database connections are there. So web.xml file is there, everything is configured. So inside S1, you are using database username, database password, driver name, driver URL, everything you are using. Again in S2 also you are using driver name, URL, port number, username, password. Here also you are using driver name, URL, port number, Oracle username, Oracle password. Even in servlet 4 also, driver name, port number, localhost, Oracle username, Oracle password. For some reason assume, like try to understand the context. For same reason, there is something wrong with the database. So you have changed your password. Assume previously my password is admin. Now I changed my password to not admin, admin 123. My updated password is admin 123. Now previously your web application is perfectly fine. So in your database, you change your updated your password admin to admin 123. So it is reflecting all the servlets. Am I right or not? By doing one modifications in your database, for example, port number is 1521. I will tell you one more scenario. You have designed port number, so all your servlets are working perfectly well. For some reason, 1521 is having some trouble. Now the port number is changed to 1522. So for example, in your application, 10 servlets are there. What you have to do? In all these servlets, manually you need to go to the corresponding Java program, open the servlet, and wherever you are using the port number, you need to change the port number. In S1 you have to change, in S1 you have to update, S2 you have to update, S3 you have to update, S4 also you have to update. For example, 10 servlets are there. In all the servlets, it is the responsibility of the programmer to open each and every servlet and you have to change all the values. So today you changed, okay. So after 2 days again you change for some reason. A new person comes into the picture, so he will update the password. Again, what you have to do? You have to open all the programs. It is very difficult task. It is very complex task. So here, what is happening? Instead of concentrating the business logic, you are keep on changing the values. There is nothing in updating the value. Am I right or not? So in that case, what the solution is? In web.xml file, we have one more option called servlet context. Servlet config is over. Now I am telling you servlet context. Servlet context means if I keep one parameter here, I want to reflect this value to entire web application. Irrespective of number of servlets you are having in your web application, number of servlets you are having, for example, these are the servlets. Inside you are having S1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These are servlets. So in web.xml file, what is my objective is, I want to put one value. This value must reflect to entire, all the servlets. Previously, servlet config means for each and every servlet, you have to individually configure. If you modify, for example, for S1, in S1 servlet, you are putting servlet config, so that will reflect to particular servlet only. If you write servlet config for S8, so this will apply for only S8. Remaining things will not reflect. But the second thing I am talking about is servlet context. The next concept is servlet context interface. The servlet context interface is, irrespective of number of servlets you are having in your system, for entire web application, you are going to set these parameters. For your entire web application, you are going to set servlet context. If you set parameters in servlet context, so these parameters will reflect to entire web application. So then what did you understand the difference between servlet config and servlet context? Servlet configuration is meant for individual servlets. So let me go back to your previous program to make you understand. Go back to web.xml file. Let me maximize it. Now here in this case, you are setting the configuration parameters to which servlet? You are setting these configuration parameters to which class? Only demo underscore servlet config. For example, similarly, I want to set the parameters to my servlet. Again, what I have to do? This entire thing need to be copied and you need to set this servlet here. So these parameters are only for these A and B are parameters to this my servlet only, and this A and this A both are different. This AB is different from this AB because where this A and B is located inside my servlet. Again, this A and B are located in demo servlet config. This A is different from this A. If you modify this A value, this will reflect to only as demo servlet config. If you modify this value, this will reflect to only my servlet one. So that means servlet config is bound with a particular servlet. Understand? Let me put it in a sentence. Servlet config parameters are bound to particular servlet. Understand? Now I am talking about servlet context. Servlet context is not bound to any particular servlet. It will applicable to entire web application. So that means, where is the location? Let me show you the code for this one. Now you see the syntax of how to set the context parameters. So now this is web application. Immediately you are writing context parameters. So this is previously you are writing init parameter. Now I am writing context parameters. So where is the location? Inside web app. Previously I am writing inside the servlet tag. Now I am not writing servlet tag. Inside a web application. Context parameter, parameter name, parameter value. Second, this is reflecting about first one. Similarly, I am writing one more parameter. Second one. If you want, you can write n number of parameters. So now these are called context parameters. Now you see the location in web application. Now let me update this one inside our Eclipse. So what is the time now? It is 4:07 already crossed 4:08. So now not possible for me to demonstrate. So it will take at least 10 to 15 minutes. So did you understand theoretically what is meant by satellite context parameters? Please respond in chat as 8888. Please respond in chat as 8888. What is the how the context parameter is different from configuration parameters? If you understand, you just visualize the concept. In tomorrow afternoon, we are having 2 hours skilling hours. That time I will demonstrate the context parameters, and I am going to complete your servlets concept tomorrow. 2 hours we are having context parameters and servlet with JDBC, and one more important concept is servlet chaining. That is also very, very important for your test examination and your end semester examination. It's configuration, context parameters, configuration parameters, and servlet chaining. These are very, very important for your campus placement interview. Technical interview, during your technical interview, they will ask you what is the, how the configuration parameters are different from context parameters. What is meant by servlet chaining? So these two are very, very important during your placement interview point of view. So with this, I am winding up today's session, because time is not permitting me to demonstrate the context parameters. We will discuss this continuation in our tomorrow skilling hours. So tomorrow, never absent, I am going to talk about a lot, servlet with JDBC, servlet chaining, and this demonstration. So tomorrow I am going to complete your entire JDBC with servlet and JDBC. Thank you. You can leave now.